I am Betnijah Laney, and I'm a guard forward for the New York Liberty. I come from a long line of strong, independent women. My mom, for as long as I can remember, she's been teaching kids basketball, and so I was just always around it. Just everything that she's accomplished, both on and off the court, has been something that's inspired me. So to be able to do, you know, some of the things that unfortunately she wasn't able to, just it really means a lot. When I first entered the WNBA, I have to say I was a bit nervous. I wasn't the scorer that I am. My role was solely to just play defense.
Oh, Laney picked her pocket.
It definitely was challenging because, you know, as a player, as a competitor, you want to give more. But it just wasn't the opportunity that I was given. It wasn't the role that I was given. I had to just continue to do what I was doing. I had to continue to grow, and eventually my opportunity would come. And it did.
Laney gets it to go.
In 2020, everything changed. I was picked up by Atlanta. Someone saw my value and, you know, wanted all of me. I went from just being a defensive player to a two-way player. That year, I received the WNBA Most Improved Player of the Year. I think that's just where I realized who I was and what I was capable of.
Nice putback,
I loved, you know, my coaches and my teammates and everybody in Atlanta, but I just felt like New York was the best place for me. We have great basketball players and also great human beings on this team. That goes a long way, especially when you're trying to win a championship.
Be better than what we were yesterday. Let's go.
And I mic'd up. I wasn't going to tell y'all because I wanted to be authentic, but I am. All right, 1, 2, 3.
All right.
Yeah, I think, you know, both on and off the court, me and my teammates, like, we're pretty close.
Like a goalie, when you wear a different... The person that stands in front of the net, that wear a different color shirt than everybody else.
Even today, I am helping one of my teammates out with her fiance's birthday.
It's crazy. This was all planned in literally an hour.
On Sunday is JJ's fiance's birthday, and unfortunately, we're out of town. So this is kind of the only time we could do something to celebrate her. I mean, I think it's important, you know, to kind of build that kind of family environment. You know, because these are the people that we spend the most time with.
Aww. Yeah.
Today is game day. Being 8 years in, I feel like game days are a lot different than when I first started. I feel like I'm a lot less anxious.
I feel like now it's just so, I'm so used to it.
Coming to my game will be my mother and my 18-month-old niece.
Look at Cam.
I think she's like the highlight of my day when I see her. She's definitely my newfound inspiration. I just want to be, you know, that person that she can look up to. I feel like she's definitely going to play basketball because even now, I'll take her out on the court and she's like, ball. So maybe she'll be like a lot better than me. I know for my mom, she enjoyed having a daughter grow up, and even though I didn't get to see her play, but just kind of following her footsteps. And so, you know, hopefully that's my niece and she'll continue our, you know, our legacy.
Thanks so much, Betnijah. Thanks so much, JJ. Back to you, Chris.
Thank you, Megan. Just a little shy there.
This has definitely been a journey for me. It hasn't been easy, but I've just kind of continued to stick with it, continued to grow, continued to just try to be the best me that I could possibly be. And, you know, now I'm in a position that I haven't been in before. You know, I'm on a team where we're possibly be competing for a championship. That's huge because that's just always been a goal of mine.
Laney takes it herself, knocks down the three.
If there was anything that I want people to take from my story is that, you know, anything is possible. Just stand strong in who you are. And, you know, it may not seem like it, but things will definitely happen.